Hello, ladies, and welcome to your holiday challenge for the day. I'm really excited about this guest because it's nice to have diversity in the challenge. We've got a lot of coaches, but what you often don't see behind a coach and her business are the team and the people that support the coaches. And so Rachel is a really incredible website designer and brand specialist, and I'm really excited to have her here today to really give you a different kind of a challenge and also to have her a part as of Mentor Masterclass. So, Rachel, thanks for being here and thanks for being the woman that you are and the support that you are to coaches in the world. And I'm excited to hear what challenge you have for the ladies today.
Awesome. Thanks so much. I'm really excited to be here and be a part of this.
Yay!
So I'll dive right in. My challenge for you guys is to create a vision board. The thing that I love about this the most is that there's nothing more inspiring about creating a vision board. So that helps you dream up a new idea, a vision for a project. Pretty much anything you want to accomplish can be done with creating a vision board. In the past, I've used it to help me design my rooms in my house, come up with things that I want to accomplish for my personal goals, whether it's health, whether it's relationship goals, whatever it is, you can dream it up on your vision board and help manifest the things that you want in your life. Basically, the way that I go about creating a vision board is I start by trying to figure out exactly what I want to get clear on. Whether it's, like I said, let's say you're designing a new room in your house and you want to start that project, figure out how you want people to feel, how you want to feel, really dive into it. So step number one would be to create a Pinterest board. If you don't have Pinterest, you can totally do this real life, get some magazines, whether it's color swatches, anything visual that you can find. The point of this is to start getting visual, dreaming, desiring, wanting, accomplishing all those great things. So that's step one. Step two would be to write down whether it's like three words that describe whatever it is that you're creating or trying to create or dream. You could write three words to help you really get clear on what you're trying to visualize. And then step three is finding things that support those words or visions. So whether it's like a color that you love or a feeling that you want to feel, I like to tell people, this is not for me to give you rules. This is for you to just like be totally creative and let loose. There's nothing. A lot of the times we go through our day-to-day being very like, there's rules, I can't do these things. Like the visual board is for you to kind of let loose and nobody's judging you. Just put it all out there. So I tell people to pin or, pull all things that are colors, textures, fonts, words. I think even, you could go as far as like, places that you like or
Oh,
kind of ignite
locations.
that feeling. So like let's say you want to feel calm, you could post pictures of a spa or waterfalls, or it can go in any direction. Obviously this is very general because people can have all different types of vision boards. So that's really step three, is to pin all the things that are brand related, images, colors, textures, and whatnot. And then the fourth step is to take a picture of your board and share it with everybody. And I know that a lot of the times, and I can attest to this, but I don't love sharing my vision boards with that many people because it's kind of personal, You don't want everyone to know your dreams.
I love as you're saying that, Rachel. We have a sneak peek of your vision board behind you this whole time that we're all trying to stare
Exactly.
at.
Exactly. And it's not something that you share with everybody, but if you want to, it's a great way of kind of declaring your dreams and visions to the world. And I find that it can be really hard to say your dreams out loud, and and even like dream up things that you really want, and to share that with people can be very vulnerable. So if you want to just take a picture of one part of it and share it with us on social media, or, you know, any way, or if you just feel comfortable sharing with a friend, I think there's a lot of power in sharing it with somebody. So that's the full challenge.
Rachel, I love that you're sharing this challenge, because at the heart of it, if these women are really thinking about becoming coaches and leaders, at some point, and maybe some of you already have to put yourself out there in the world, and usually that's through a website, which is the work that you do in the world. And my experience in ushering women through this year-long course is that the creation of their brand is in a really emotional process. And you must have this all the time with your clients, and that it is really vulnerable and tender. And there are a lot of questions around, what do I want and how do I share that with the world? And I think what you're asking them to do in this simple way, whether they decide to do it around their brand and how they want that to look, or whether it's around designing a room in the house, it's asking them to work the same muscles that they're going to have to do to put themselves out there, to share themselves, and to have the right clients come in and resonate with them. And exactly. So I imagine you do this with your clients, obviously.
Exactly. And yeah, I mean, speaking to that point, it's a super vulnerable process in general, like just diving into your dreams or wants, or whether you're branding yourself, going into that deep place where, again, not a lot of people get to go to that place with you. So, you know, a lot of the times you see the finished product and you don't really see the full process. And it takes a lot. It takes a lot to dig into yourself. It takes a lot to put it out there. And I think that I feel so honored that I get to support women and, you know, people through that process with their personal lives and their business, because a lot of the times they're connected. Mm-hmm. So, you know, there is the business and the person, but with entrepreneurs, a lot of the times, you know, we're full circle. We're kind of, everything is together. So.
It is. And that, I think that's the hard part is sometimes I think there's a way that we try to separate that. We try to separate who we are and how we want to feel and our personal visions from our professional work in the world. And that really is what creates a brand, I think, when you're able to merge those. And I love what you said about not making this like a ruled process, because it's when you try to like follow the rules and do what you think you should do, or copy how other people decide what their vision is, whether it's for their brand again or for a room in your house, you actually start losing yourself. And so I really feel like this challenge day is opening us all up to creativity, which is less rule-oriented and is more about finding expression. And there's so many different ways that we can do that by saying, how do I take what I'm thinking or what I'm feeling and put that into a visual? And what does that look like for me?
Exactly. And it is about expression. And I think that whether it is your personal self or your business, it's a form of expression, how you're sharing what it is that you're, you know, putting out into the world and sharing with others. And I think that everybody has a story, whether it's with their brand or their personal self, and diving in and doing these vision boards really helps you get clear on that part. You know, whether it's like you're not sure what you want to put out there, whether you know, you're just afraid to share it all with everybody. This helps you at least start somewhere and kind of really, really get clear. And I think that's what most people are looking for. So
I have a cool story about this too. I just wanted to share it, because I decided to do this when my husband and I were looking to move out of New York City and buy our dream home. And we really had, it was kind of an unexpected decision. Like, we weren't planning for it for a long time. It was like our lease just went up crazy and we're like, okay, we're going to do this. And we basically had 2 months to buy a house, which is crazy. And we're not planning to buy a house. We weren't even planning to move out of the city. And so I began the process by starting a Pinterest page and just starting to pin different pieces of homes that I liked. And like you said, one picture was of the ocean and water, how I wanted to feel. And I made this Pinterest board, and then we started looking looking at houses, and I just happened to get a fairly woo-woo real estate agent. And I told her, I created this Pinterest board, and she was like, well, why haven't you shared it with me? That's crazy. You know, send it to me. So I did. And then the house, my dream house that I live in now, which is by the beach, that we bought within a month of deciding, really came together because of that Pinterest board and sharing it with the real estate agent. And then she was able to use that vision to help me manifest my dreams. And we, like, the synchronicities in the house that we found, it's like it had this exact spiral staircase that I had pinned in my Pinterest board. And it had exact wood beams that were from another picture that I had pinned from a random house or in our main living room. And it's by the water. And so I also think that this visualization is the art of manifesting too. It really does. And for a website for your brand, I think it is manifesting, calling in your dream clients is really what happens when you create that unique brand and beautiful site.
Exactly. And that story is so perfect. And I have a similar one as well. It's just, I just bought a house in May and I was all over the place that I want a house, an apartment, like all different types of things. But when I went to my vision board, everything looked the same. It was like, it was so clear in the vision board, but in my head, it all felt like, this is not clear. I don't know what I want. But when you really look at like the things that your heart is drawn to and the different parts of yourself that are coming out in these, you know, whether it's like the colors, the textures, the actual images, you start to see like, wow. And now looking back at that board and seeing the house that I live in and I created for myself, it's so perfect. It's like, it couldn't, it's like, I really, people would have thought like, you planned this whole thing, didn't you? And I did, you know, you kind of do. And part of the Pinterest board idea in my mind is it helps you plan and it helps you figure things out so you can make decisions so you can get the things or, you know, manifest the things that you do want. So it's super powerful.
Yeah, I love that you mentioned that you felt the overwhelm and the lack of clarity, but then in the end, it was so clear. That's how I felt in our house process too. And that's how I felt building my brand. I was like, I don't know. Like, I don't know what my brand is or who I am or how I want it to look or what colors or what font or what I should say. And I did a Pinterest board process for that too. And it does become clear, you know, and then when the final product comes out, you're like, wow, I'm surprised I was ever confused because it really came out exactly how I could have always wanted it. So,
and honestly, that's like my favorite part about what I do is that I help people really get clarity on their brands. And a lot of the times they come to me and they're in that overwhelmed state where nothing is clear, but I don't kind of experience it that way. I'm like, no, you're so clear. It's you know, it's all there, but they need my help to kind of pull it out of them and organize it in a way that they can visualize it and so can other people. So it's a super amazing, fun process. I like think that this is kind of the basis of my business in a sense. Like I really live in this space so much when I'm creating with clients. So I just love it.
Yes. So ladies, thank you, Rachel, for sharing this with us today. And ladies, I'm so excited for you to have that sense of feeling around whatever it is that you want to direct your challenge around today. And I do hope that you'll find the courage to share it with us because that's the extra step out, is that willingness to be a bit vulnerable and share your vision and let us witness you in it. And more importantly, when you can have a community of powerful sisters holding that vision for you, I think that up levels the manifestation process of it coming to be in fruition. So take those steps that Rachel noted today and use the hashtag MM Holiday Challenge if you're willing to share with us, especially inside the group. I'll share Rachel and my hashtag, our handles below so that we can witness you in this journey. Rachel, thanks so much for this beautiful challenge.
Yeah, thanks so much.
Thank you, Rachel. Thank you, ladies. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye.